Okay, so the first thing that I'm going to show you guys how to make is this DIY pom-pom garland. So the things that you'll need for this is two colors of your favorite color of yarn, a really big fork, and some super sharp scissors. Start off by taking your yarn and you're going to go ahead and wrap it around your fork. Now, I wrapped mine around 75 times, but you can do it any way, any amount, there we go, from 50 to 100 times, depending on how big you want your pom-pom. Once you've wrapped it, go ahead and just cut it off. Now cut about 5 to 10 inches, depending on how big your pom-pom is, of yarn, and you want to make sure that you have enough extra so that you can tie your pom-pom on later. So now go ahead and just put your yarn through one of those little fork, I don't know what you call it. This is kind of hard to explain, but just look at this video clip really closely and it will make a lot more sense. But pretty much you're just wrapping it around the fork, and then you're going to do a basic slip knot around your yarn. And what this is going to do is it's going to secure the pom-pom so that your pom-pom doesn't just like fall off into nothingness when you take it off your fork. And then you just want to go ahead and do the same thing on the other side just to make sure that it's nice and tight. Now that you've done that, go ahead and just cut that that giant loop of yarn, I guess, that keeps it on your fork. Just go ahead and cut that off right down the middle on either side. And what this is going to do is it's going to make your pom-pom. So it actually is like a cool looking pom-pom instead of like this weird looking pom-pom. So definitely make sure that you do that. Now go ahead and just take your pom-pom off of your fork, and then you're going to go ahead and just kind of fluff it around and tie it, make sure it's nice and tight. And then also what I recommend doing is take your scissors and cut little small pieces of it off. And what this is going to do is it's kind of going to fluff it up a little bit and just make it a whole lot cuter. And I did this for around like 5 minutes, and I'll show you guys what the pom-pom looked like. There we go. That's what the pom-pom looked like afterwards. Afterwards, which I think it looks super adorable, and it's just like way more fluffy. And then to attach it, all you're gonna do is just do a simple slip knot super duper tight onto your other piece of yarn. And then you just want to go ahead and make as many as you want. I think I made around 9 or 10 for my garland, and it reached about 5 feet. So just depending on how big you want your pom-poms and how far apart and how long your garland is, you want to make more or less pom-poms. Now here I'm just showing you guys, I attached mine to my curtain rod, and I kind of had a hard time tying it on, so just like bear with me right here, but it was pretty easy to put on, and I think the colors are really pretty. You can totally change these out. I made like a red and green one for the holiday season, but I thought for Valentine's Day I'd do white and pink. And that's what it looks like. And I also just added some Christmas lights and then also some little red bulbs, or what is it, like little light covers, and I got those from Target onto my lights. And that's what it looks like. I think it's super gorgeous and super pretty, and it just adds a little sparkle. And then also to my curtain rod, I got this ornament set. Actually, my mom got it for me on like clearance at Target, and they're just 4 little red hearts, and I think they're really cute. And all I did is just I took some thread and I just tied it onto the heart, and then yeah, just pretty much tied it onto my curtain rod, and it also adds a really cute little touch. So now I'm going to show you guys how to make this glitter block, I guess you could call it. You can pretty much spell out whatever you want, but I decided to go with love. So the things you'll need for this are some wooden blocks, a pencil, some glitter sticker paper, and some scissors. Start off by tracing your letters on your glitter paper. I was spelling out love, so I had around four blocks. Actually, I had four blocks. There we go. And I just took a pencil and I traced it around. It's kind of hard to trace on glitter paper, but it kind of like indents it more so you can totally see it still. So I just traced them all out and I sped this process up because it took me like 5 minutes to do this, but it's totally worth it in the end. And another thing that you can do is like take some felt or some fabric and change up the textures. I just totally went with like glitter paper, which I really like. And I'm just cutting it out here, as you can tell. And with my O, I went back later and cut out the center because it was kind of hard to tell exactly how it was going to lay on the O. So I just cut it out and then I stick it on my O and then recut it out. It will show later, but here I'm just cutting out all of my letters. I saw lots of these things on Pinterest, and lots of people were just using Mod Podge and regular paper, but I thought it'd be so much easier and a lot less steps and a little more inexpensive. I got this whole sheet of paper at Michael's for 89 cents, I believe, and then the blocks were around $1.15 a piece, I think. But anyways, you can just do whatever you want, but I think that the sticker paper is super easy because you don't need any adhesive. Okay, so now that I am done cutting them out, I just peeled off the back protective paper and stuck them onto my letters. And make sure that you are nice and careful with this so that you don't, like, stick it on wrong or anything like that. And make sure that you stick them on nice and firm and tight and just make them look good. And here I'm showing you where I puncture the hole in the middle of the O and then cut it all out just so that it looks really, really nice and clean. And I found it was a way easier to do it this way. And then I just hot glued them together, and there you go. I think this is so, so cute, and it adds so much color to my room, and just makes my room look really cute. And then another little touch that I did is I just got some candy hearts, or conversation hearts, or whatever you want to call them, and put them in a little dish. And then a few little last touches that I did is I just added my red heart pillow from Target to my bed, obviously, and then I also added this little pillow, which I actually made out of, don't judge me, it's just some fabric, but it was actually like towels, and I just attached it to a pillow, so yeah, I know that looks kind of tacky, but whatever. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Make sure to go check out my last one for a Valentine's Day giveaway, and I'll see you later. Bye!